Judge Escobar, so...
Yo, Mike, let me holler at you.
I'm gonna kill your wife.
I just want you to know this, Mr. Escobar.
So, what time's court start?
Mr. fucking Jermaine Maximilian Francois DeMarquis Rob Pearson Pendragon, okay, man? What the fuck?
Jermaine Maximilian Trance de Marquis Robespierre Pendragon, the third Escobar attorney at law, the assistant district attorney for the state of San Andreas and all excluded territories, as well as the appointed chief marshal for the second federal district court.
Yo, speak up, bro. I can barely hear you.
Oh, God. This is going to be fun.
Fucking day. As soon as it pops up, you just know. You just know. It's like you see it, you're like, oh no.
When he's got to pull out a badge for each part of his name.
Who is this? Like, hold on, let me flash this at you 6 times.
My badge is actually a 17th century Chinese scroll, and it just rolls out.
Can someone appoint Mr. Corbin back here to the courtroom? In the council room?
Where's he at?
I don't see Corbin here.
He was here? Okay, he disappeared.
Might be up in the main lobby, Elliot.
Wanna look? I'm getting him.
I gotta piss.
He said, Angie, better give me my paycheck.
So who's going to jail today?
Hey, you did, Mr. Corbin.
Doing pretty good.
All right. Submitted no motion for discovery, no evidence. What the fuck, Corbin?
Dude, honestly, I legitimately don't know. Like, the whole situation, and this is why I texted, you know, him earlier. I was like, dude,
how many of the PD are threatening and intimidating you? Probably all of them, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, I figured.
What the fuck you mean, don't leave the courthouse? What the fuck's that supposed to mean?
It'll be alright. It'll be alright.
It's okay. I submitted everything as if a motion of discovery was apparent anyway. She can see it was all put in there.
You understand why this is being pursued upon review now, right, though?
Right. And in my defense, too, I honestly wanted some more time.
What's up your ass today? You work up for you.
No, you're fine. I don't know.
They have a right to a speedy trial, and they want it to done last night or today. So we will. The state is more than happy to comply with their request and uphold their right to a speedy trial.
No. That's not me.
Yeah. I don't know how it's going to turn out. Just try to present the best evidence that you can, or whatever that you can. Obviously, Jermaine's a fucking lethal weapon over here, full of evidence, so I don't fucking know. All I know is, based on the evidence that both of you provide, is going to determine the outcome of this trial.
Get off his dick.
As for the police intimidating you, or whatever, we'll figure that out after. Don't worry about that, man.
He said, is there anyone with a 25 that's relevant?
Because it's crazy how it's everybody's fault but the people that did it.
Yeah.
You know, it's my fault, it's your fault, it's their fault, it's everybody's fault but the people that are involved. It's crazy how that works.
What? Yo, Rick.
I have something I'm supposed to be doing right now, and here we are.
Shit, okay. Yeah, I just say we just roll with it, you know, that's all we can do.
Yep. When we get out there, I will have a pre-trial motion.
I have my prompt already. I mean, we're ready. If everyone's ready, I'm ready. Call on Radio 20, by the way, in case no one can hear.
Nah, niggas that sit beside the angel is crazy.
Okay, let's see here.
I've just communicated to Corbin a piece of exculpatory evidence, which I intend, once we go out there, to motion for admittance into evidence.
Try to use only key points. Don't, even though you have all that evidence.
I'm not going to look at every piece. Can we agree that we will allow me to only reference the exhibits and not to specifically go and look at all 50 videos, fucking 10 documents, fucking however many photos. I've just referenced them as exhibit V50, V49.
Right, yeah. Okay, here's my question. What, assuming that we're going to review at least a couple videos, which ones are we going to review on?
If you want to review any of the ones I've submitted, you feel free to, but I've entered them into evidence, and I feel that due to court time, I'm specifically am going to trust the judge to review them when he goes back to...
Make sure you send me all the links of all this...
I've sent you the link of my legal brief, which has them all specifically referenced in there. Would you like me to share that with Corbin? I know I've given him all the evidence, but it doesn't list which exhibit is which. One moment.
Yeah. On my brief.
What's up?
Like, they can
what do you mean?
It, but it's still gonna...
I'm not that. Yo. Alright, mate. Public
execution. Oh, it's dog. Okay.
Swear to God. Why can't I sit the fuck down?
Flex your ex. It's just a lot of people. It's like people to show you stuff. Oh, the only people that you know that I know that you know is me, Jess, and May.
And, everything in there is the stuff from the little lamplight dossier, which he's already been provided, as well as all of the additional videos I've submitted into evidence up until the deadline.
Are we ready to get this party started after Corbin's done?
Yep. Whatever you guys are ready.
Yes, I've gone ahead and sent you that along with my legal brief. So we have both the exhibit list and the legal brief for you, Your Honor.
Yo, smoking in the courtroom? Crazy, no? Yo, John John's dead. Someone revive that nigga.
I'm walking away. You're wild.
Yo! See ya!
Boys are ready to rock, take your stand, and I'll come out, and we can all live.
Are we wanting to yell, Corbin, or speak on the radio?
You said what?
We could try to yell, but I think probably... I don't
radio.
Know.
The last time we did it, we had to do radio.
Okay, we'll do radio then.
Yeah.
I did
possible. Someone hit me with an inch. No. Are you fucking ready, Jermaine?
Oh, fuck, I've been ready for the past 5 hours.
Oh, alright, let's get this the fuck over with.
Someone call EMS, John John dead.
Banger or no banger?
No banger, turn on some peep.
That's your thing, bro. Just give it a second.
I mean, I know this song.
What is this bullshit? It sounds familiar.
Please turn off your music, guys. We're about to start.
Yes, ma'am. It's going to be the walk-up song. You feel me?
Everybody, court is in session. Everybody, take your seats.
Music off.
Sworn in.
Music off.
Get music on. Turn your music off or I'm going to throw you in jail. Literally.
Yep. Yep.
Out the way, God dang it.
There's two different charges.
Dope. Ugly ass hat.
Humble, you missed it. We're free PD.
Alright, but so what we doing? Mike's case, JJ's case also? Like, how's this even going?
Sure.
No, I'm just saying, like, how are they doing this?
Yeah, you guys are listed as co-defendants.
Ain't nobody asking you, Freddy.
Yeah. I mean, I got a case on my own, so I would like to be. Yeah, I mean, if you got cases against me, it's on me. So, I mean, my shit, JJ shit, that's on JJ. My shit, that's, you know what I mean, that's on me. So, I'm just saying. I don't know how y'all want to
be here, you know?
Come on.
Okay, let's go. Let's go.
Here.
Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit.
Yeah, yeah, we'll be back.
All right.
We'll be back.
Are we all ready here today? How we doing, boys? How's everyone? JJ,
yes, sir,
Mike, is Mike on there? Mike, JJ, word, everybody's 20. On the radio that needs
yeah,
to be here that I can see. Alright, guys. Now, I'd like 20. To just start with good afternoon. You know, 20. For those who don't know me, I'm Latavius Keys. I'll be pervading over, you know, the court trial today as a substitute judge for Honorable Ball of Fam. Before we begin, I'd like to outline, you know, a few guidelines to ensure that this is a fair and ethical trial. So, to state the most efficiency, I guess to say,
how do I lean on the
it's imperative that we remain, you know, respectful throughout this entire thing. I don't want no one just wilding out, acting fool, none of that.
Bar.
And you know, the biggest part here is I'm going to emphasize this 100 times over and over again. As the judge, I am neutral. I am going to make my decisions based solely on the evidence present, like, you know, presented in front of me today, because I know everybody here. So, you know, there's whatever. I'm going to try to uphold the most unbiased persistence at this trial that I can. So, other than that, I encourage you guys to openly communicate, you know, cooperation between all parties here. That would be great. You know, if there's any concerns, anything that needs to be addressed, don't hesitate to say it. And mostly importantly, the goal is to seek justice and resolve the issues here at hand so we can get this the hell out of our lives. So let's begin. Like an opening statement from the defendant.
Shut up.
Your Honor, should I read the...
Go ahead. Yeah. You can read the accounts of what we're here for. Sorry, Jermaine, I forgot. We can bring that back up.
Your Honor, Jermaine Maximilian France de Marquis Robespierre Pendragon III, Esquire Attorney Law, Assistant District Attorney, here on behalf of the state and the people in the matter of San Andreas v. Mike Fucito and J.J. Aflack. The defendant, Mike Fucito, is charged on 7 different counts. Count 1 consisting of the first charge of corruption. Count 2 consisting of the first charge of aiding and abetting. Count 3... the second charge of corruption, count 4, the second charge of aiding and abetting, count 5, the first charge of sale or distribution of items used in the commission of a crime, count 6 being grand larceny, and count 7 being misdemeanor obstruction of justice. The defendant J.J. Aflack is charged on 4 counts, with count 1 being corruption, count 2 being felony obstruction of justice, count 3 being evading, and count 4 being the murder of a public servant or law enforcement officer.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Jermaine. You may be seated. For the record, will the defendants please rise and state your names?
That's us.
Yeah, yeah, that's us. Right,
you go first. You go first. Oh, you go.
JJ Aflack.
Yeah.
Hello, JJ.
Mike Fucito, the chief.
Looking beautiful, Mike.
Appreciate
you. Alright, you guys may be seated. Any evidence that the prosecution has may be presented at this time, so we can begin cross-examining witnesses.
Your Honor, I would like to make a motion to enter into evidence, exculpatory evidence relating to emails by Mike Fucito, indicating that he intended not to show up to court today in contempt of the court.
Motion denied.
10-4.
Yeah, he's at court, bro. What are you talking about?
You're dumb.
All right. One moment.
Mr. Marquise.
Yes, one moment. Your Honor, I'm having a slight headache.
No, yeah, you're fine. You're fine. Before we get started with the evidence, can we court why we are all here today beyond the counts with the affidavit?
Yes, I'll make my opening statement, Your Honor. If it pleases the court, the evidence, testimony, and arguments you were heard today will prove beyond any reasonable doubt that Mike Fucito and J.J. Aflack have committed the listed crimes and have shown no remorse and a disrespect for the law and towards the court. They may try to raise any doubt possible, but there's no reasonable doubt as to the crimes they committed. They may beg for a reprieve or try to beg for mercy to Mike Fucito and J.J. Aflack, I say to you. Pray to God for mercy, for I have done for you. That is my opening statement, Your Honor.
Would the defendant like to say, or would the defense like to have any statements?
Yeah.
That's deep right there, bro. That's deep.
Right.
Hi, so I just want to say something. Mike Fucito here. Some of y'all know me as Unc. Some people know me as the chief. Some people know me as Mikey. Just want to come up here and tell you guys I am not guilty and I am falsely being accused here.
Same.
What's going on here?
Yo, chill.
Alright, we'll start to take evidence from the prosecution side. Actually, yeah, we'll start with the prosecution side.
Thank you, Your Honor. As agreed, pre-trial, we were not specifically be reviewing any of the 47 listed video counts provided in discovery. They will merely be referenced in my oral arguments. All right. On the 2nd of March 2024, Eilish Flores was arrested by Officer Monkey while attempting to murder another law enforcement officer, and she was found to be in possession of PD equipment. This shows a habitual nature of offense, specifically relating to more events similarly to follow, and evidences her conduct predating the ride-alongs, allowing her to masquerade as a PD sheriff on March 12th, as well as on 3/13, and her disposition to murder officers of the law. Evidence in Exhibits P6, P5, and P4. This relates to Fucito Count 3 and Count 4, evidencing that Fucito knew or should have reasonably known as a reasonable and prudent law enforcement officer of her past before engaging in ride-alongs as per SOP guidelines to check on persons' records as well as search them. On 3/8/24, SRT Curto and Jose Williams engaged in a firefight with multiple officers at the 827 Innocence Boulevard 67 gang compound. After additionally killing three officers, including James Smith, Kai Beelan, and Deshaun Monkey, after killing said three officers, Mike Fucito and Jermaine DeBarkey arrived on scene, apprehended the individuals. After medical, back at MRPD, SRT Curto and Jose Williams nephew of Mike Fucito, indicated to Mike Fucito that the crimes that they did indeed shoot at officers. After some debate and disagreement from now-resigned officer Kai Bielan, Mike Fucito issued his nephew and his friends weapon licenses for the weapons which they previously possessed without such, and released them from custody without charge. Mike Fucito was informed by Marshall DeMarquis that Jose Williams was ineligible for a weapons license, and Mark Fucito said it was okay because Jose Williams is his nephew. Less than an hour after murdering said three law enforcement agents and being released and issued weapon licenses by Mike Fucito for unlawfully possessing firearms used to murder three law enforcement officers, nephew Jose Williams and SRT Curto were seen shooting and chasing a civilian by the name of Donnie Andrews, and then upon felony stop, they fled the scene. This is all evidenced in exhibits D9, a D8, a D4, a D34, a V35, a V36, the V37, V38, V39, V31.
Calm down. 1 second. Back it up. Got V31, V38, V39.
Yes, I do have my oral arguments presented in written form, so you could relate to that later, Your Honor.
Okay.
All right. This relates to Fucito Count 1 and Count 2. Yep. Mike Fucito, by using his position of power in public office and to get the release of his family member and friend of family member for multiple murder charges with evidence, and Mike Fucito himself being witness and also assisting in the arrest to quite a large portion of it, and issuing them weapon license despite being informed their ineligibility. His action constituted corruption with Mike Fucito's direct support through his office, aided and abetted Jose Williams and SRT Curto in their ability to continue to escape justice and violated the law. He violated his duty to public trust invested in him by his public office and the people of the city, and furthermore demonstrates a disregard for the lives of his officers if it means benefiting a family member of his through his position of office of power. On 3/12/24, Eilish Flores was permitted to have PD equipment by Mike Fucito, and Mike Fucito indicated she was a PD sheriff multiple times, including to a Captain Humble legend. Mike Fucito indicated over radio she was PD and a higher-up to LSPD Captain Legend, evidenced V24, V27. Eilish Flores went on several ride-alongs in PD uniform with Mike Fucito and J.J. Aflack, witnessed by multiple officers listed herein. During these ride-alongs, she indicated she was a sheriff, including in the presence of LSPD Mike Fucito and an officer-involved shooting by the casino, as evidenced in V2, V3, V6, V8, D6, P3. Eilish Flores is indicated to not have actually been hired onto PD, nor did she apparently at the time possess a PD job or PD job access, only having EMS job access and privileges. Eilish Flores was present at a scene with an officer-involved shooting and continued to identify her as a sheriff, furthermore evidenced in V3. Eilish Flores, during an altercation with an officer Dingle Wingle, in which she was accused of pretending to be a cop falsely, brandished a weapon at said officer before holstering and pulling out a metal lawn chair, with which she struck Officer Dingle Wingle in the presence of J.J. Aflack, Richie Forzi Jr., causing near-death injuries. This was at 761 Center Street, Mission Row Police Department. She then ran into 755 alleyway and was pursued by Cadet Richie Forzi Jr. During the pursuit, Officer J.J. Aflack used it. Is this gentleman supposed to be here in the middle of the courtroom?
Remove him.
I'm just a spectator.
Ah. She then ran into the 755 alleyway pursued by Cadet 4Z Jr. During the pursuit, Officer J.J. Aflack used a taser to incapacitate Cadet Richard 4Z Jr., so Eilish Flores could escape, which she did do due to the violent aid provided by Officer J.J. Aflack to stop her arrest for the crime she had committed in his presence. He then fled the arrest to avoid potential arrest or consequences for himself, as evidenced in V7, V8, V9, V10, V11, V12, V13, V14, V15, V16, V17, V18, V19, V20, and videographical exhibit V21. Mike Fucito indicated to multiple officers, including Humble Legend and Toasty BB, that Eilish Flores was the new PD sheriff, as evidenced in V23, V24, V2, V6, V26, and D3. This relates to Mr. Fucito's Count 3, Count 4, Count 5, and Count 6. Mike Fucito is seen to have knowledge of her masquerading around as PD sheriff, in line with testimony, affidavits, and statements given by multiple officers. This further shows that he was fine with her masquerading around as a sheriff, since she is his niece, despite her criminal history and continued violation of law, including murdering, most notable of which includes several officers of the law. Mike Fucito's direct material support by distributing PD equipment of great financial value used in the commission of Eilish Flores' crimes, as well as using his office to falsely give officers the impression that she was a sheriff and that she was above them, directly aided and abetted her ability to continue to escape justice and violate law, violating his duty to public trust invested in him by his public office, constitutes corruption, and furthermore demonstrates a disregard for the lives of his officers if it means benefiting a family member through his public office and position of power. And this also relates to Aflack's Count 1, Count 2, and Count 3. J.J. Aflack is seen and reported by Officer Humble Legend and Forzy Jr. to have witnessed the murder attempt on Officer Dingle Wingle in front of MRPD by Eilish Flores, and then proceed to flee, with J.J. quite purposefully using his position and items afforded to him as an officer of the law to taser Forzy Jr. to prevent him from catching Eilish Flores for the murder of Dingle Wingle. He expressed guilt and fear of consequences by fleeing from Officer Forzy Jr. J.J. Aflack's actions constituted a breach of public trust and his use of items of a peace officer to assist a friend in escaping justice constitutes corruption, felony obstruction, and his flight therefrom constitutes misdemeanor evading. On 3/13/24, Eilish Flores was arrested around 6:30 a.m. Central Standard Time on drug sale charges, as well as being in possession of stolen PD equipment and EMS equipment. She was arrested by Toasty BB and Richie Forzy Jr. as evidenced in V4, V5, V6, P1, and P2. She was let go after it had been falsely communicated to them that she was an officer, a sheriff, and above them. Earlier in the morning, around 1:30 a.m. Central Standard Time, Mike Fucito over radio indicated that she was PD, and she was the higher-up to Captain Hubble Legend as evidenced in V23. In internal PD emails, Mike Fucito indicated not to issue a warrant for her arrest nor to pursue any further investigation. He indicated she was not an officer, contradicting his past statements of his, and indicated going forward she should be processed as any normal civilian, further instructing and implying she should not be detained, arrested, investigated, or issued a warrant or in any manner formally held to have consequence under law for the crimes that she had just and previously committed, further indicating for her multiple crimes, including felonies, drug trafficking, attempted murder, and murder of law enforcement officers, and various other offenses should not be prosecuted in this instance, by stating going forward she would be treated like any other civilian, furthermore stating he would talk with her instead of a warrant being issued or charges pressed, completely against common LEOPD and DOJ standard operating procedures, common practice of law, and in violation of public trust and multiple ethics codes as evidenced in V1. Eilish Flores later tried to extort PD officer Richie Forzi Jr. to return her handcuffs, threatening to have Mike Fucito fire them, as evidenced in V6 and V2. Related to Fucito, count 3, count 4, and count 7, Mike Fucito's aiding and abetting by actions done by him under the purview of his position of power in a public office continue to allow Eilish Flores to act with impunity for any crime she wished to commit. Furthermore, he used his public office as a position of chief of police of the Los Santos Police Department to try to override a captain's request to get a warrant that was for Mike Fucito's niece, who had killed Officer Dinglewingle. His impediment resulted in the warrant being delayed and Eilish Flores being able to escape justice to do nonviolent obstruction by directing ADA DeMarquis not to get the warrant in an attempt to prevent her from facing consequences. She later killed officers Pilot Sanchez as well as Chris Stanton, which could have been avoided if she had been held to account on time and the warrant issued on time. On 3/14/24, J.J. Aflack and Eilish Flores killed Chris Stanton at 761 Mission Row Police Department at approximately 12:10 a.m. Central Standard Time, then fled the scene at high rates of speed shortly after killing Pilot Sanchez, as evidenced in V-32, V-40, and D-5. Howard Uduin released them from custody without charge after they received medical in the garage of MRPD. This relates to Aflack count 4, J.J. Aflack is seen videoed and reported by Officer Humble Legend and Pilot Sanchez, who have murdered Chris Stanton in front of MRPD, with Eilish Flores assisting. On 16/24, Mike Fucito was served an arrest warrant at his gun shop after being called down there. He was secured without any lethal or non-lethal force being used, only handcuffs being applied to his person while held at gunpoint and taser point. He was Mirandized and threatened to fire those officers executing the signed warrant for his arrest upon him, as evidenced in V-33.
Your Honor, can
Mike Fucito.
This is irrelevant to my client.
Sir, this is, if I may, this is completely relevant. It speaks to his state of mind and his belief in the need for him to obey the law, and will be relevant
about
for his sentence.
Doing the charges, bro. Shut up.
Okay. Only Jermaine talk. I'm going to approve, Jermaine. Keep going. Just keep going.
Thank you.
Objection denied.
Mike Fucito was then transported over Vespucci Boulevard Bridge 761. Before managing an escape attempt, he ran across the MRPD steps but was reapprehended shortly after, as evidenced in V-44. He then popped head while cuffed at a police cruiser, and J.J. Aflack showed up inquiring about his uncle, referring to Mike Fucito. He was arrested on his outstanding warrant, as evidenced in V-44 and V-45. Mike Fucito then flew back in, and despite being handcuffed in a vehicle when he had head popped, was unhandcuffed and began attacking officers and attempted to escape again, but was restrained with non-lethal force and taken into custody in V-45. Mike Fucito then tried escaping after breaking cuffs while at the courthouse cell entrance, as evidenced in V-46. Mike Fucito, while being suspended temporarily by Commissioner Johnson in the chief's office, indicated he would fire everybody involved in the arrest on him. Shortly after, he called a friend and suggested that he would ask him to come and shoot all of the, referring to both the officers and the marshals, in the head at the MRPD cell he was in, as evidenced in V-42 and V-43. J.J. Aflack and Mike Fucito were continuously offered food and water and both declined the need for any medical attention while in cells. J.J. Aflack and Mike Fucito requested their lawyer and Corbin Blue arrived. Later, upon release of Mike Fucito pretending his court case, employees of his in his presence attempted to effect an arrest of the marshals and officers who had just arrested Mike Fucito lawfully with a signed warrant for arrest from the Chief Justice Latavius Keys, stating the grounds as arresting the only ES member in city at the time he was taken off his bike, despite him in the clips, body cam, and dash cam radioing to other EMS members on his radio while handcuffed, one of whom is EMS worker Ellie Keys. Also, at the execution of the warrant, J.J. Aflack was not on a call and instead investigating the arrest of his uncle, as evidenced in V-41 and V-44. They released all persons arrested very shortly after realizing and being informed by Chief Justice Latavius Keys they were thrown their case by attempting to arrest the opposing side on notwithstanding charges. That is all for my arguments and examinations, Your Honor.
Okay, that you're lucky I'm the fastest type in the world, Jermaine, because wow. Either way, okay, before we go to cross examining witnesses, would the defense like to make any statements? Corbin?
Yes. Can we, call Mike to the stand?
Yep. Mr. Fucito, please come.
So, I'm gonna try to go over some stuff that, Jermaine kinda, you know, went over and asked you questions and answered them as best as possible, basically.
The defendant is waiving his Fifth Amendment right, correct?
Sorry. Tell the truth.
Oh, excuse me.
Yeah, you know the deal, Mike. I believe you, man. Go.
Okay.
So, basically, Mike, I'm going to ask you a couple questions on all the stuff that he went over with you, basically, and instead you just answer as best as possible.
Sir.
So, we're going to go on the first one. The first one's going to be with the...
Mr. Bros.
Sorry.
Okay, I'm just going to go with some of the stuff that I can think of right this second. I'll just keep on going back and forth. So, with the Eilish situation, as in when she... Did you ever let her be an actual officer? Did you ever hire her or anything like that to be an officer with PD?
Excuse me. Oh, sir. I strictly told the guys as well to... if she was doing stuff that incriminated her, to proceed as if it was a regular... pedestrian and take her in and proceed as we have on our SOPs.
Was there any active warrants out for Eilish's arrest?
No, there was not.
Okay.
I did not have any keys, which proved I did not ever hire her into the police department, and nobody else hired her into the police department. That's why she wasn't able to go inside anywhere in the department. If somebody allowed her inside, then that was on them. But she was not inside that building while I was on duty.
Got you. And did you ever see Eilish represent to be a police officer on the streets?
I believe I had seen her with some kind of body vest. It wasn't a police issue body vest. Yeah. I'm not too sure what kind of body vest she had on, but it definitely was not the police body vest that we wear.
Got you. And then with the PD equipment, can you explain that? I'm pretty sure that PD or EMS does have equipment that PD uses too. Is that correct or no?
Correct. So I'm not too sure what they compensated from her. But she is an EMS worker, and they have very similar items that we have as well. As far as anybody in my department, nobody in my department issued her or gave her any kind of items that we use on our police department.
Okay. Another thing is, too, that you let two two people go on an incident. Apparently they were shooting. Can you explain to us about that a little bit? Why they were let go?
Yes, sir. So on that incident, you had a guy there who was just a regular civ dude. I believe he had said the guy's name. The guy was shooting at gang members and taking their items, robbing them on point. In this town, they don't really do that. Gangs mess with gangs, civs kind of mess with civs kind of deal. And that probably should have never even happened. But I don't know what happened in that scenario there. I just know that the guy was going around robbing gang members and other civs and stuff like that. These guys retaliated, got their stuff back, and that's when they was, got in trouble with the cops and everything like that. When they had explained their situation, I had brought it up to the Supreme Court. And, I came up with the conclusion of how we wanted to handle it. And the idea of how to handle it was to charge them and let them go. If this guy was to ask me why or how or what was the situation, why I was letting them go, then he would have understood. Not only did we spend about half an hour talking to these guys, which is about jail time, but the situation of how everything happened, probably should have never even happened. And because of the situation of what happened, that's the reason why they were fined and they were charged. And the guy who got the license did not shoot at a cop, so he was issued a police, he was issued a license for his car as well. So that's the reason why they was let go. Not only did they serve the time in the garage while we was going over everything, but they also was charged and then let go after. So it was not like they just came there and was smacked, got a little slap on their butt and here you go, keep going. No, they got charged and they was punished as if anybody else was to be punished. And for record, the person who was in there is not my nephew, not blood or anything like that. People around here tend to call me unk and things like that because I'm a very respectful person in the city and I look out for people and not in that kind of way. If you go against the law, then you're going in and it's that simple, and anybody who knows me knows that's how I do it.
So when they call you like unk and stuff like that, that's just like all street talk, right?
Well, street talk, it's all love, it's like they have the respect for me, so they call me unk,
Got you.
Big name.
What else did I have here? I think that's all the questions I have right this moment.
Alright, you may be seated, Mr. Fucito. I have no questions.
May I cross-examine, sir?
Oh, yeah, you're fine. Alright, Mr. Fucito, sit back down. You're being cross-examined by the prosecution.
How are you doing today, Mr. Fucito?
Terrific.
That's good. So you're quite a respectable guy, you say, and you say anyone, you find out it's broken law or anything like that, whether they're family, they're a friend, you don't tolerate that. You're a straight shooter. You bring them in, lock them up, right?
Yes, sir. I mean, you should kind of know that. When you stepped into the department, I told you what it was as well,
I do. I really appreciate a straight shooter, Family, friend, they don't act biased. They go and arrest them when they commit a crime. That's very respectable. So when you had knowledge that the person that you've identified as your niece, Miss Eilish Flores, was falsely identifying her as an officer to get out of charges after murdering a law enforcement officer, and a captain requested the warrant for that person, you said, go ahead and get that warrant. Is that correct?
Go ahead and get that warrant. Can you elaborate a little bit on that? I don't...
Well, that would be, you don't tolerate that, you're not biased, you go and lock them up. Someone requests a warrant, a family member's done a crime, you'd be fine with them going and getting that warrant, correct?
That is correct.
I see. And when that had been brought up to you by Captain Humble Legend, and he asked me to get the warrant, what did you say, sir, about getting the warrant? Did you say to get the warrant or not to get the warrant?
So, if you're talking about in emails, then what that was, as I was bringing it up to the Supreme Court so they could take care of that, unlike us taking care of that, because I didn't see us taking care of it. So the Supreme Court would have probably put down the law a little bit more better.
I understand. So you're saying that she was, you definitely went after her and got her charged with the crime she committed then?
She was talked to, correct.
Talked to. But she wasn't charged. She wasn't, as you said, locked up and, you know, whatnot.
If she was caught doing something that was against the law, then yet they, whoever was on duty, which I believe I was not around or on duty at the time when these incidents occurred, then I would have put her in myself and locked her up and threw away the key, correct?
I understand, but you definitely get a warrant on someone if they committed a crime, right? I mean, that's standard operating procedure. They get a crime and get away, you get a warrant, correct?
Yes, sir. That's what we have you here for.
I got you. And they requested me to do that, and you told me not to, as you said before. Could I ask you, after I did get a warrant on her for all the crimes she committed, last night, when offered the opportunity of her location and knowledge that the warrant was active, what did you say about PD serving the warrant, sir, you and Andrew Glatt? What do you recall being said?
I don't remember that. If you want to record to me, the only thing I remember is when you had wrote to me on an email about if you should, that you are building up something, you're getting it together. I told you, don't worry about it because I am going to take care of it. And I took it to the Supreme Court and it was talked to and it was handled.
I got you. So you don't, do you recall or not recall saying something along the lines of yesterday, it's PD's not going to serve the warrant, it's not our fucking job? Do you recall that? And I do apologize for the profanity, but I do believe I'm quoting almost exact what you said, sir. Do you recall that?
No. I honestly don't recall that. If you have anything of me saying that, I would love to see that. Yes, sir.
I got you. Well, perhaps we could get that. Do you want to take the time to get that, or would you like to move on?
No, we can move on, but you could send it in the time being, please.
Perfect. Understood. So, could I ask you, a civilian, hypothetical question, robs two other guys. And when the police show up on scene, those two guys run and end up shooting the cops while illegally possessing weapons. What would you do in a circumstance like that?
Can you repeat that, please?
Theoretically speaking, in a circumstance where two people were robbed by another person, and when the cops arrived on scene, the two people who were robbed fled, and upon the cops attempting to make contact with them, they killed the officers because they were in legal possession of the firearms they had on their person. What would you do if you were in city, on scene, for something like that?
If anybody shoots at any of my cops, you're going in and you're getting max time, max fine.
Perfect. So in a similar situation to that theoretical question, did you give SRT Curdo and the person you identified as your nephew, Jose Williams, max time, max fine?
They did get charged. They didn't get max because of the situation that was brought up to the Supreme Court. So, that's the only reason why. If it was, let's say another gang or something like that coming at them, you know, anything in that situation, then, yeah, for sure, they would have for sure been max time, max fine. Because of the circumstances, it was a little bit different, and it was a tricky situation.
I got you. It's been two Supreme Court situations with nieces and nephews. Can you recall off the top of your head any other case where you have brought in something to the Supreme Court that did involve someone you've identified as your niece or nephew?
For record, they're not my niece and nephew. That's first thing. Second off, is usually those things are brought up to the Supreme Court by itself and they are handled by them. So these situations, don't know how it got on my desk, and I brought it up to them myself.
So there's no other situations that you could think of off the top of your head where something like this has happened?
No, sir.
I understand, sir. And how common is it for people to shoot at cops and be released and given gun licenses for illegally possessed firearms?
That's a tricky question. It really depends. If it's on their record and it's over a certain amount of time, then I believe everyone's allowed to have a license depending on the time that they had done something like that.
I apologize. I feel I might not have communicated clearly enough. In an instance where someone shoots at cops and are then brought to cells, how many instances like that happen where instead of being charged, they're released and given weapon licenses?
If you shoot at cops, if that is the situation, then we will revoke your weapon license.
I understand. I think that's all I need from you, sir. Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure speaking with you today.
Okay, would the defense like to call anyone to the stand at this time? Defense, any more witnesses?
give me one second.
I could put JJ on the stand, but I don't know how much that's going to really help us. So.
I'll allow it. I'll permit it if you would like to take that route, but I'll just for this, I'll allow it.
Yo, look up in the air, bro. Naked people in the scene. When I told everyone that she is not...
If there's no further witnesses from the defense...
Hold on.
Oh, did he pop hit? Oh, I was going to say, did he fall out on him?
You got basically half the damn state here.
Is Andrew here?
Yeah, it seems so.
Can somebody unlock the courtroom door?
Yeah, I'll do that.
I got it.
Can we call Andrew to the stand?
Objection, Your Honor, I provided my witness list. They provided no witness list or any witnesses they believe to call. A discovery is closed, and I do believe they should have known or reasonably know that Andrew Glatt had information that he could be witness to it. I do believe this would be a violation of standard court practices as well as evidentiary rules to enter him after the closure of the discovery, and given that a similar denial to evidence I wish it to enter after the fact was denied, I believe it should be done the same here, sir.
He's
said all that in one breath.
Okay, there's no further witnesses on our side then.
Would the prosecution like to begin to call witnesses to the stand?
Your Honor, we don't believe it's necessary. We believe the evidence and affidavit speak for themselves. We are prepared to move to closing arguments if they have no more oral arguments.
I was going to say, let's move on. Well, I'm going to say, no more evidence to submit from the defense? We're pretty much... Alright, well, let's move on to our closing statements.
Yeah, I mean, we can have JJ go up there.
Well, I was going to say, if you would like to summon Mr. Aflack to the stand, go ahead.
Yeah, can we put Mr. Aflack on the stand, please?
Mr. Aflack, please come to the stand.
Let them know I was not with her. Not right with her.
Inspector Gadget, you look good.
All right, Mr.
You look fine as hell.
Swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth throughout this trial.
Yes, sir.
I don't think he's available. I think he's taken.
Okay. So, JJ, were you ever in the car with Mike on a patrol?
Hey, buddy.
No.
Nice to sit behind guys, huh?
And do you work for
EMS? Right behind me, don't you?
Part-time? Yes. Part-time or full-time?
Part-time.
What is some issued equipment that you get as an EMS worker?
Would you like it if
get
I got behind you?
They're used by both PD and EMS.
So basically, universal, right?
Yes.
Gotcha. Give me one second, looking through more notes. And JJ, can you tell us the situation with you and Eilish and Chris at the PD station? What was exactly happening at that moment?
It with the cameras when you guys were playing around practicing. Remember that moment, JJ?
Like,
is fighting in the courtroom, by the way, stop. Whoever you are upstairs, I see all of you, and I'm gonna hold you in contempt of court till this is over. Ellie, fucking, yes, all of you, stop right now.
Security, go get him.
JJ, you there?
Here comes the SWAT team.
Hey, I saw you from across the room.
Oh, just bring Ray.
You can hear me, right? Okay, okay, JJ's. Okay, I'm just waiting for JJ.
Wait, JJ, you still there? Or do you have a headache? He might have broke. Dude. I had a
sorry.
Headache. Oh, okay, okay, okay.
I'm so sorry.
You're making me hungry.
Yeah.
You're making me hungry over here, you alright?
Yeah, I think JJ's having some problems.
Yeah, we have like a weird... There's something might happen. JJ, we can't...
Watching this shit.
Yo, free Mike Smacks!
Hey, can you uglies keep it down back there? I'm trying to pay attention.
Free JJ!
Shut up, ugly. Don't say that again, ugly.
Fuck up.
Yes, yes, there we go.
I love Corbin Blue.
So the situation when you guys were outside the police station was Eilish, and looks like it was Chris. You want to speak about that situation?
We were doing a training exercise right outside of PD because there was PD inside of the building, and we were trying to see what they would do. We had no intention to shoot, but since nobody would come outside to, you know, participate in the training, we had to.
Gotcha.
To get them to come outside.
And you work with Mike every day, is that correct?
Whenever he's clocked in and whenever I'm clocked in. We kind of cross paths sometimes.
Got you. How often do you think you guys cross paths?
Maybe 3 times a week.
Okay. And how is he as a boss?
Really good. He knows how to enforce the laws and set everybody straight.
Okay. Have you ever seen him do anything corrupted?
Negative.
If you had to explain Mike in one word, how would you explain him?
Confident.
Confident as in, like, in what he does?
Confident in, yeah, confident in law.
Further questions? Is it me or we all broke?
Not on my end, no.
The prosecution like to come ask any questions at this time?
Yes, Your Honor. How are you doing today, Mr. Aflack?
I'm alright.
Got one question for you. You are aware that during this thing that you're labeling as a training exercise, Chris Stanton did die as evidenced by his injuries, correct?
Yes.
I see. And, instead of stopping immediately, you fled, sir?
It was all part of the training exercise.
I see. So there were a training exercise that resulted in one officer dying. You're saying that you did flee, and you are aware that another officer was injured by you at Elish Flores and nearly died by the name of Pilot Sanchez, correct?
I was not aware.
Alright. That is all, Mr. Aflack.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, you should ask what they had outlined for the term.
Gotcha.
All right, let's move on to our closing statements. Let's start with the prosecution. Anything the prosecution like to say?
Yes, I have a closing statement prepared, Your Honor.
Would you like to say anything when we close it down? Like, you know, speak to the public?
Honorable Judge Latavius Keys,
the
court, citizens of the state of San Andreas, the officers who arrested Mike Fucito believe the city deserves a department that enforces the law impartially, without bias, and one that does not enforce personal desires or invent vendettas of the chief of police. They had everything to lose, despite the risk, despite no reward. Officer Pylon Sanchez risks his job, freedom, and life for the city because it was his duty. Despite the risk, despite no reward, Captain Humble Legend risked his job, freedom, and life for the people of this city because it was his duty. Despite the risk, despite no reward, Officer Forzy Jr. risked his job, freedom, and life for the people of the city because it was his duty. Despite the risk, despite no reward, Marshal Toasty Beebe risked his job, freedom, and life for the people of the city because it was his duty. Mike Fucito believes that as chief of police, he and his family and friends can act with impunity from the law. They believe they can murder cops, murder civilians, obstruct and impede the execution of law. Mike Fucito believes he can rule as an autocrat that can fire officers who arrest him and his family with a signed warrant from a chief justice. He believes everyone in the city must answer to him, including the judiciary, including, as he said himself in the videos, Latavius Keys. Mike Fucito would fire half of the Los Santos Police Department who has testified against him, provided evidence against him, and assisted in arresting him and his family. Mike Fucito believes he can keep officers who murdered their other officers and civilians who flagrantly break the law. Mike Fucito's niece and nephew, Elish Flores, and J.J. Aflack believe Mike Fucito's protection make them immune from prosecution or consequence, no matter how frequent, habitual, apparent, flagrant, or gross the crime they commit. Mike Fucito believes he can solicit people to murder officers while in cells because, as he said, he is chief and it is his station. Mike Fucito believes the law must respect him, and he does not have to respect the law. He's confident that the law works for him and that he does not work for the law or for the people. I believe the entirety of the corpus of the DOJ and of the government will show Mike Fucito that he is not immune from the law, that his position does not afford him special treatment. Some may see this as a chief of police who will try to get out of clear, evident crimes, that will think he can use his friends to get out of consequences and then act with impunity to those who upheld their duty, to punish them, despite the personal risks to them for upholding the law. I think that unlike Mike Fucito, the Honorable Judge Latavius Keys is not corrupt and will not allow personal bias or friendship to stop him from executing his duties as an officer of the court and upholding the law. I think that unlike most of the people that have been victimized by Mike Fucito, many of which are in this courtroom today, the Honorable Judge Latavius Keys is not subject to intimidation or fear by Mike Fucito, despite what he may believe. I know in my heart Latavius Keys, like half of the Los Santos Police Department, will do his duty, not for personal gain or benefit, but will do the honorable judge's duty to uphold the law, will set aside any personal bias like so many officers have. I know Mike Fucito will be convicted for his crimes. I know J.J. Aflack will be convicted for his crimes. I know that this city will not be the city that dies after the corrupt police chief gets off scot-free and fires all the clean officers who did their duty to protect the communities from those who murdered, stole from, and victimized so many. I know the city will overcome the hurdle that will be the one that operates off of friendships. This city will be the city that survives Mike Fucito. This city will be the city that in 2 months' time is not empty, but thriving with those oh so many civilians that though they can live, knowing that rules decide what is and what is not, and not an autocrat, it is friends who see the city and all of you in this courtroom today as toys in their sandbox. Your Honor, everyone in the courtroom, and to every victim of Mike Fucito and J.J. Aflack, rest assured, the good officers of the Los Santos Police Department have done their job. The United States Marshals have done their job. The DOJ has done its job. And now, Chief Justice Latavius Keys, the Honorable Presiding Judge, will do his job to uphold the law and to hold Mike Fucito and J.J. Aflack accountable to the law, despite their position or any personal bias. The state rests its case, Your Honor.
Hey, Judge, head pumped. Give it up, y'all. Give it up.
How long ago did he head pop?
All right, guys. That's, just now. That's everything. Thanks for coming. See you guys later.
That's crazy.
He's coming back. Don't worry.
Hell yeah. Hell of a speech, by the way. Can we give it up for Mr. Jermaine? Can I get some class in the courtroom?
Hell no. Hey, that boy was annoying as hell.
That man was yapping.
Broken record head ass.
Freddy Krueger looking at it. Nigga.
We appreciate you, man. That
y'all
was
niggas
great,
hating. That nigga was cooking down there.
Shut your bitch ass up.
Bro, dude. Bro, ChatGPT, that shit don't even.
Pablo is a murderer.
Gambino.
Hey, what Pablo do?
Hello, Gambino.
Pablo Escobar equals good man.
Good shit, Jermaine. Good shit.
Oh, I'm in the courtroom.
And then Mike, you want to do yours as a closing speech?
Where's Gambino?
Okay.
Jermaine. Mr. Jermaine, how do you feel that they said they used that APT?
Yeah, man. Yeah. Yeah, we should be.
What the? Oh shit, you okay?
Yo, free Mike. Yo. Love you, big dog. Yo, free Mike, yeah, jury.
The judge is flying back in. He'll be here momentarily.
How much money you want? Okay, shit. I don't give you shit. my neck, my back. Free Mike. Yo, what's up, Judge?
Can you please step off the courtroom floor, please?
So this is my seat.
Bro, I'm an old guy. Bro, I'm an old guy. This is precious. Yes, sir.
Bro, where the fuck is the tuna chip at?
Bro, I don't have it. What the fuck?
You're the last one who took that shit, bro.
No, I give it to Judge. He took it.
We'll talk after, bro.
Yeah. Bro, my back. My neck. My back.
Good.
Come on, Gambino, sir.
Yes, sir, bro.
Give Toasty his seat back.
My seat? I've been sitting here all day, bro.
Are you on this side? Or are you on my cup's side? Or are you on Jermaine's side?
He flew out. He's gonna be back
out there. Huh? Oh, you're asking him. I was like...
Whose side are you on, sir? You on ours?
I thought Bella was gonna be the judge.
And if you're on ours, you sit over here. If you're back in the chief, you're up there.
I'm back in the chief. Humble, you're back in
the chief. Over there.
How's your day going?
Fantastic.
Sure, not too bad.
No, I'm taking my mask off.
Honestly, I was just out selling drugs, and then I swung by, and I seen there was a fuck ton of cars in here, so I figured I'd swing through and see what's going on.
You said what?
I don't know if you want to go after me. That was a hell of a speech, though. I'll give him that one. Hell yeah. I don't know how it's going to go. But
yeah, I think we're just going to do the closing speech and kind of just go from there, man.
Oh, God. I'm the new judge.
I don't think it ain't looking too good for him right now.
Yeah.
JJ, bro. I got you, man. I love you, JJ.
Can Bobby back for that 400K? The others,
yo, free JJ and free Mike Fucito, bro. You guys are bugging. They didn't do nothing.
Ready?
PDK.
Make the city better again.
Yo, please step off the courtroom floor.
Who?
Whoever's screaming PDK. I don't know why you're screaming that.
Yeah, that's kind of what I was thinking too. I was outside the police station. She did tell me she was a cop.
I meant kudos to PD, like kudos.
Yo, okay, come here fast, right again. Bro. What the? I gotta hear you.
Forget it, bro.
Come here to me fast, bro.
Free Gambino, let him walk again.
Hey, bro, free me.
Yo.
Me.
Dingle. Yeah, I thought we was already closed. I thought they already had a chance to speak, and then they asked him to speak, and then we're gonna get this shit over with.
Yo, if I start shooting inside here, do I get arrested?
Okay. Yes.
Oh shit.
What do you think, guys?
Nah, you don't get arrested. You good?
This is the wrong radio Gambino.
Don't listen. It's a setup.
Yeah, someone told me their size, that's why I came over here. Oh, okay, then I'm gonna go back over there. I just came over here because Toasty...
Hey, everybody back in the courtroom? He's back.
Come on. Let's go,
welcome,
JJ.
Mr. Keys.
That's the truth. Sorry about that.
Everybody.
Oh, good. Keys, can I say order in the court, please?
Same
one time.
Yeah. You said
what? Alright, and we're ready for the defense's closing statement. Sorry about that.
Use your chat.
Ladies and gentlemen, I appreciate every single one of you guys for coming here and listening to this, taking your time off to hearing everything that's going on here. Just want you guys to know that when I took the chief position, and even when I was a cadet, one thing they told me, you know, they asked me too, if you saw a friend or family, what would be your situation? How would you react to them? I told them straight up, I don't care if it was my mother, I would lock her ass up as well if she was committing a crime. I have MDTs that will prove and show you that I have friends, I have family, I had people who I'm closest with that I had locked up and put behind bars. It doesn't matter who you are. If I have that vest on and you're committing a crime, then you're going to jail. I took this position to make this department good again. And since I have, everything has been good. We have been growing. There has been more officers. We've been having fun. We've been taking we've been doing a lot of stuff here and improving the department and moving the way it's really supposed to be moving. And we have people who, they see the shine. They see where we're moving in the department. They see, the growth of others, and they wish they could have that. And there's always going to be people in this world that's going to knock you down. There's going to be people
Ian, shut the fuck up for a minute.
Yeah, there's going to be people in this world that's going to knock you down and not want to see you up top at the end of the day. And I'm used to that. And people like this, they're not going to stop me. You know, they see people doing good, and they hate to see it. I'm going to keep doing what I'm going to do. I'm going to be the best chief that the city could see here. I'm going to make sure that we're locking up and taking out these drugs. We stop countless bank robberies. We stop drugs off the street. We stop gangs from fighting. We put behind a bunch of stuff. You could check the vest. You could check the MDTs. You could check all this. It's proof in the pudding. The stuff that this guy is saying about me trying to drag my name around the ground, it's really inappropriate if you ask me, because anyone who knows me knows that I'm a good man. I'm where I'm at for a reason. And I'm the chief of this town, and I look forward to keep bringing it up and up and up and making sure that everyone is doing what they're supposed to do. You do not get special privilege. Even my mom knows that. I told her if she does a crime, she's going to jail as well. So it really doesn't matter who you are. If I have that vest on and you're doing something you're not supposed to be doing,
fuck you, mom.
You're going to jail. And this guy must not really know me if he's assuming that I just give special treatment and I take friends and let them do whatever they want to do, because that's not how it is. If I'm on duty, you know what time it is. PD on top. But yeah, that's really my only statement. I look forward to keep doing what I got to do and make PD the best PD that I ever was. Anybody who knows me and everybody who serves by me knows what I've been doing here with the department is the best it ever was before. And we continue to grow. This is a little bump on the road, but I'm going to have people like this. We're going to have people who are going to be hating on us and not want to see us grow, and they want to be where I'm at right now. And it is what it is. I'm prepared for that. I'll come to court, and guess what? I'm going to beat
Mike
like Little John did. You know what I'm saying? So that it is what it is. I'm going to continue to do this. And
saying the same shit over and over.
LSPD on top. I could say.
PD ass, nigga.
Appreciate you guys for coming.
Just your bitch ass.
If you say one
thank
more
you.
Word, I'm going to say
womp,
every
womp,
word.
Nigga,
okay.
Womp,
okay.
Womp, nigga.
Okay, got you, bro.
Appreciate you guys for coming. And that's pretty much my closing statement. I am an innocent as can be. And, yeah, that's it. Mm-hmm. I hope the jury can see it.
So
I hope
JJ.
Mr. Keys could do it. I appreciate mm-hmm. everybody for doing the job. And I also
would like to say to everybody.
I also appreciate the DOJ as well for. I also appreciate the DOJ as well for doing their job, and I understand, you know, the circumstances. Yeah, they thought she was my niece, and they thought that I was giving her special privilege and all this other stuff that was going on. And they're just doing their job. I don't blame them for that. They're doing a great job here with everything that they had to say here and stuff like that. But at the end of the day, I'm here to do a job. I'm here to have the law down and make sure everybody's following and we have a safe city here. That's what I signed up for when I became chief.
I hope, Aquarius Marcus, blah, his name is over here. He could see through that and see that I'm actually a good man and I'm here to change PD and make it the best that it ever was. Appreciate you guys.
All right.
That's it. That's it on our end.
2-4. Give me 15 minutes to come to a verdict.
All right, everybody, recess. Come on.
That was good, man.
Hey,
guys.
Oh my God,
that was really good.
Hey, that's good.
Hi, Victoria. What's up, sir?
Yo, KB.
Gambino.
Damn.
Put your bitch ass up, KB.
Shoot out, everybody. Shoot out outside.
Oh, excuse me.
Shoot outside. Oh, yo.
Shoot outside.
Holy shit, I can't even get up.
Like, you won?
You think you're innocent?
Yeah, David,
I
can't
know I'm innocent. I did nothing wrong.
Yeah, we don't think.
Nice.
No.
I know for sure.
Nice.
Who called EMS in here?
Hey, Jermaine.
Somebody
no matter what happens, bro, you did a great fucking job.
He said 500K for the last person standing.
As entailed.
Shoot out outside.
And I just like to say, no matter what happens in the future and today, I got mad respect for you. Appreciate you doing what you do.
For you too, Mr. Toast.
Oh, well. There's Kimba.
What did you say about that 500K, Dunja? Yeah, they said 500K for the last person standing. Shoot all outside.
What?
At the end of the day, whatever they choose to do here, as long as, you know, the PD, I know the commissioner, Jacob will make sure everything is good around here. So, you know, at the end of the day, we'll see what happens. We'll see what the verdict is. And hopefully they can
really comes down to the end of the day, you're still a business owner, and it's not like PD is paying bills, you know?
Yeah. No, I do this because I like
you protect and serve.
See the motion.
Protect and serve, Mike.
Yeah. Mike claims they bleed over here.
Oh, this stress. Hell no.
Dude, you don't make it.
Yes, sir.
I vouch for you. Don't make
it. Oh, yeah.
PDA and ADA connects
with money. It ain't nothing. You know, I got the best people. I got family. I got people. I got this. You know, I do PD because I love what I do.
Oh, snap. The judge is back up there.
I love
it. Let's see what the judge. What did they say?
Gambino.
Is he good or what?
What's that take? What's that take?
Gambino.
I think he's going down.
One of my favorite
yeah,
people.
Yeah, it'd be nice if you were in the chair. Yeah, escort it out.
You came to support.
I'll get up. I'm sorry. Here we go. Take
Okay, nice.
Which one are you talking to? Me?
I was talking to
her.
Oh,
yeah,
that's why
you
missed.
My name.
I was talking to Nate, but she acts like she don't hear me. Unbelievable. I can hear you now.
Let's go, Mikey. You got this, dude.
Yo!
Can't
keep
my name
out of her mouth.
I appreciate it. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what happened there. With this. Yeah, appreciate it. I didn't do shit at all. I don't have nothing to do with that woman. You know, she did what she did, and at the end of the day, it is what it is. I have nothing to do with that.
He needs both of you guys in the back.
Yo, Gambino.
It is what it is.
Yes.
Haram.
Wait, are you a lawyer?
Who's this guy?
Hmm?
Wait.
Whoa. Hey, what's up, man?
Hey, how you doing, Pablo?
What's up, True? Welcome.
Hey, what's good? How you doing?
Hey.
So what are we pushing for, boys? Because I've already made my decision.
I'm assuming
guilty
you're...
Guilty one count, please. Guilty one count, obstruction of justice. Guilty one count. Pretty much everything guilty, honestly.
I've got a... After this...
I can't
this...
dispute the evidence, man.
Yeah.
You might have a good little voice, you know. That's... I can't... That's not going to work here, man. I'm sorry.
We appreciate the decision. I'll, after enough time has passed, review a possible record expungement for Mr. Fucito, given his contributions to the city, but that's going to have to come well after the verdict on the trial today. I'll get him and Johnson sat down and talk with them about the DA's office, and I'm assuming, Trey Webbs, you'd be okay with that?
What's up, my name? What's up? Everybody,
yeah.
Welcome back.
All right.
I'm the new judge.
After quite a bit of time, In case he does decide at some point to come back to the police department, obviously people commit crimes, and
Mike
after a death time separation, you know, they're eligible for a record expungement, especially, you know, given the entirety of the context of their circumstances. So maybe in a month or two, he could give it another shot in PD, and hopefully he'll learn from his mistake
Mr.
here.
Gambino, don't
but,
call on the stairs
I'll
now.
Speak with those two about that after
Yo,
the
wow, break. You hear him? He say, I'm a Muslim, I cannot be judged. Wow.
Where's the party
That's fucking
at?
Racist, bro. Yes. I'm gonna arrest your ass now.
I guess my question then becomes is...
You're not arresting shit, arrest
which
me inside
way does the
your room.
Go from here?
It'll be up to Johnson. That's outside of our purview.
That's my question. That's my big question here. Yeah, I'm with you. Yeah,
yeah.
I don't understand. You know what's going to happen from here, Trey. It's going to be a shit show and a war. And we're going to have to figure that out here momentarily. But I'm going to go call. I'm going to go call my verdict.
Step in the lobby.
Yeah, you're right. It'll be up to Johnson. So Johnson will figure it out. So we'll see.
Yep.
What's the biggest dick in here? Slay.
Me.
Yeah, I don't know who the fuck just said me. Real talk, I'll slap the shit out of you. Don't ever say me.
After you read the verdict, could you indicate to them that
I
wish to have
the
meeting with Johnson and him before his sentencing?
Wait, one more time?
Yeah. Could you indicate to them that before he's sentenced, well, sent off,
your name is
after
Ian, bro. Real shit, I'll slap the fuck out of
you
pussy, suck my dick.
Could you have us have a meeting in the
conference room
so we could talk about that before he's sent off?
Yo, Ian, real talk, where you at, bro? Meet up right now, but you're not like that, real shit. We'll ride your dick and fuck you, bitch. You're not like that.
Yo. Yo, I got an automatic weapon waiting for you.
Automatic dick ready for you, buddy.
Hit you.
Oh. I'll smack the shit out of anybody.
Leo, I ain't stopping.
I hit one.
Hey, buddy.
Run
the bed, homie.
Right now, we got this shit in the
bag. Where you at? I'm gonna lead you right now.
Me didn't lead you square.
Nigga, come down LSC, nigga.
Hey,
just
chill out, boys. Let's chill out. Let's chill out on the radio.
Be there or be square at Legion Square, buddy. We're right here.
Okay, so what do y'all think about this?
Yeah,
we'll
so
we'll give public comments
shit.
Afterwards.
At the end of the day, Mike
okay,
and Jack.
Trey, do you have any comments before?
Not at this time, no.
So no comment for both of
y'all? Some
not at this time.
We'll comment at a later date.
Order in the court. Order in the court.
Order this dick in your mouth, toasty. Fuck up.
Fuck out of here, boy. You guys are so fucking weird. Everyone shut up.
Yo,
I'm
Troy, bro,
it.
Go take care of your kids. Go take care of your kids, Troy. Calm that shit down.
I'm 24, buddy. Calm the fuck down, alright?
24, you sound like that? Yeah, you,
that's
you got soft hands, brother. You got soft hands, brother.
Nigga sound like a retired Amazon driver.
It's a bitch.
Hey, you
better watch out.
Cut the music.
Cut the music.
Please,
Pablo. Go ahead.
Out
Come on, Gambino.
Call that, Miss Chester.
Shut up, Cruz.
Hey, hey puto.
Says one more out of character.
Hey,
JJ, thing. I'll see you guys
up,
in a month for appeal, okay? And I'll see you crying in your band appeal, and you can cry, I promise you. I know it'll stand for 30 days. So, think wisely.
I think I should get a free one.
Just tell me the word, Josh. I fix it.
I'm gonna be a dick. I just want to get this over with guys, okay? You know,
Yo,
I'm not trying to sit here and drive my dick down your throat.
Yeah, Bino, why you trying to look like me?
Whoa, whoa.
That's your shorty.
So I've reached the verdict.
Did you guys hear this, Heinle?
Department of Justice and Supreme Court find Mike Fucito.
Guilty.
So you're guilty on two counts of corruption, two counts of aiding and abetting, one count of misdemeanor obstruction of justice, one count of selling items used in commission of a crime. JJ Aflack, you are guilty of one count of corruption, one count of selling items.
JJ is getting sued. I got a question.
One count of evading. One count of murder.
I got a question here, buddy. Shut up.
Yo,
buddy.
Hello,
let
shut it up. Finish talking.
It's too bad you're not a cop anymore, fool.
Through your sentencing, we hereby order.
Bad,
Woo.
My bad. I got
follow.
You. I'm a
time,
quiet.
Time and a fine for both of you. The ADA and the DHA have agreed to work with both of you on behalf of your fine service for the city. So we're gonna go over that afterwards for the rest of your sentence. But right now, your sentence is just a time and a fine
and we will
time
and
a fine.
Yep. Yep.
Make the PD and Los Santos great again.
Before you leave, I need, we're good, course adjourned. I need Jacob, I need Mike, I need JJ, and everyone else, you're good to go.
Yeah,
thank
I need Big
you.
Daddy Carlos.
Okay, now
make,
can I get
make Los Santos
situation?
Great again.
We're out of session today.
Hey, can we get that man Carlos supported?
Hey, Jermaine.
Great job. That's
pretty cool. Party is crazy.
You guys would have come into the conference.
That's well. Racist.
No, it's a word for band, I mean.
That's actually racist.
It is adjourned. Have a good day, guys. Be good.
Appreciate all them bullets.
Latavius, bro, I'm gonna catch you in real. Bro, I'm gonna catch you in the streets of Los Angeles, bro. Real shit.
Yeah, boy.
Jermaine, I'm coming for you, daddy.
It's up for you, Latavius. I'm gonna let you know right now, bro. I'm gonna catch you in Los Santos, and I'm gonna fuck you in Los Santos.
Oh. Don't cry.
Yo, sir.
Dismissed. Everyone leave the courtroom.
Oh, I said, you talking about when I said there's a shootout outside, 500K?
Yo, people talk too much.
Last one standing get 500K, shootout outside. Yeah, I'm gonna shoot you in your throat, bro. What's up with that, John John? Pull up, bro. Where you at?
My fault, bro. I'm a bitch. You right.
May I get your comments now, sir, about this fact matter?
We will provide public comments to a group of news organizations at a press conference that is yet to be arranged.
Okay, and what will be happening to Mr. Mike, sir, with this coming down as him being guilty?
We will comment on that at the press conference and not comment on that at this time.
So I need some money.
Okay, so have a great day. Okay. Mr. Trey, am I needed in there too or no? My name was mentioned a lot in the evidence, so am I supposed to be in there too with y'all?
No.
No, in that meeting, no. You don't want to be in that meeting.
Yeah, man, fucked up.
You ready to go in, Trey?
Yo, you was very, very good.
Thank you. We're gonna work with
Mr.
Mike.
Mr. Gambino, you're not gonna.
He's a good man that made bad decisions.
You.
We're gonna see what we can work out with him.
But you was very good
Sorry, Mr.
to
Angel,
talk and everything.
I appreciate it, Mr. Yeah. Gambino.
Mr. Angel.
This guy, can you take him to I don't know, to prison
people.
Or something,
I
bro?
Of him
yeah,
people.
Please,
that
please.
Please.
This guy is dirty criminal.
Why you ask about it in here, in this radio? You're crazy. Tell me your location.
Our radio is 12.06, right?
I mean, hug you.
Say?
Our radio is 12.06, right? Because I'm getting off this crazy channel.
I'd like to put a restraining order against Gambino.
I'm
going to
stay here in case Keys Coles is in there.
That not your choice. You can't.
Hey,
your
can someone help me get my friend outside? His limbs are stuck. He can't move.
My coffee, my coffee.
All right, so what's your thoughts?
I think we did our job.
Oh, thank you very much.
Oh, no doubt.
Yeah, and I think going forward, the city's going to be better for it. Though it's going to be a turbulent night, obviously.
It is going to be a terrible night leaving
turbulent, sir. Turbulent.
But I don't think it's going to be a terrible night or turbulent night as well, because, I mean, the officers who are working day in and day out are dedicated to their job. They should be dedicated to their job. So.
I'm very dedicated to my job.
What'd you say?
Can we talk about me
getting
a new
job?
I don't
see them
going out
and doing what they need to do to make sure that the citizens are safe. That's it.
You'll have to speak to Johnson about that.
Are you very pleased with me?
Gotcha.
With the evidence I provided?
Does anyone know where he's at?
Yes, sir.
Well, you know, me and you still have to have a conversation.
10-9, sir. Couldn't hear you.
I said me and you still have to have a conversation one day.
Maybe sounds good, sir. Is it bad or?
Oh, it's not bad. I mean, you know, it's just, you know, if you in your life ever decide to withhold or divulge information about a case, I'm going to have to kill you.
Oh, Gambino.
Oh, sir, that was not me that told other people. That would be Mr. Mike that contacted Johnson that led to all the people being...
Dingo said next time he see you, what's up?
Dingo said next time he see you, what's up?
I'm in the car with him right now. We're driving a black track car.
Gambino, you see a black Elk?
Oh my god, okay, I'm killing him and all of you.
So Wiggle was talking to you at the
courthouse. Yo, Gambino, you see a black track car? That's me and Dingo in it.
I'm happy.
Yeah, air that shit out, Gambino.